champion Yuri Foreman is following the footsteps of Manny Pacquiao, Kobe Bryant, Rampage Jackson. We're here backstage in his locker room ready for his appearance on Jimmy Kimmel Live. Manny Pacquiao was on Jimmy Kimmel twice, 2 weeks before he fought, and twice he won. So does this mean that you're going to win?
I don't know. I hope so.
What do you guys think about Jimmy Kimmel?
He's pretty awesome.
He's pretty funny.
How funny is he? Is he funnier than Leno?
Way funnier.
Sarah Silverman's funnier.
He's cute.
Funnier than that guy on CBS, the old guy, what's his name? Letterman?
Letterman?
Oh, gosh, he's way funny.
I don't even watch him. Whatever.
Who watches Letterman these days?
Tonight on the show will be Yuri Foreman, world champion, first world champion from Israel. What do you think about that?
Israel, shalom, mashlomka. Yes.
Your weight division, Paul Williams, Kermit Centron, Sergio Martinez, Kelly Bat, a lot of superstars. Yeah. Which one of them would you want to knock out first?
To fight. Right now it's Miguel Cotto on the line, you know? I'm not looking past him.
Man, I think the Israeli's gonna take him out. Come on, man, Israel!
And Bob Arum is very good on making all the things happen, so. Okay. Ask him.
What do you guys think about Jimmy Kimmel?
I think Jimmy's funny. He's alright.
Is he the best pound for pound late night host?
I don't know. Pound for pound, he's probably one of the bigger ones.
You think he could take out all the other hosts if they had like a SmackDown?
I heard Conan's been training. I don't know.
Conan has the reach on him, I think. Conan has the reach.
But Conan can't even run. Didn't you see him slip and knock himself out?
I did not see that.
Russians have a very unique sense of humor. It's kind of dry, kind of vicious. Sometimes it's mean humor, but it's humor.
Yeah.
Israelis have a very different kind of humor. If you're not from there, you're not going to get it. Like,
yeah.
You know, Silte Buekas, Charlie Bachetzi.
Yeah, I don't get it. Just kidding.
Tonight you're going up against a comedian. How are you going to handle it?
I'm not sure I'm gonna go toe-to-toe with him because this is his job, you know. I'm not sure he would not go toe-to-toe with me, you know. So hopefully he will take it easy on me and I'm sure it's gonna be fun, you know.
We're really having a lot of fun. Today, we did an interview with Time Magazine and we're here at Jimmy Kimmel and we're with AOL Fan House and we're having a lot of fun. He had a great time listening in some of the interviews and hearing about his background from Belarus to Israel to Brooklyn, and it's been quite a journey for a man only 29 years old. So I'm very impressed, and I'm very lucky to be a part of his promotion.
Being here tonight, is that achieving the American dream? Because it's more mainstream than ever. It's bigger than being on ESPN, bigger than being on Fox Sports.
Listen, I'm still like living American dream, you know? And I came to the big hotel room, 2 flat TV, 2 bathroom, you know? Although like only one basic cable, you know? But still, you know, I'm like, wow, I'm going to be on like a lot of people going to watch it, you know? It's like awesome, you know. So I'm looking forward. I'm like, whew, man.
You're excited. Yeah. Out. For those who don't know about him, what can you share about his childhood, his earlier years?
And at a young age, after his mother passed away, he made the decision to, you know, pursue boxing after he had won a few Israeli national tournaments. And to his credit, his father bought him a ticket and gave him some cash. And he said, within a day of moving there, he had a job. And he went to Gleason's because he had read about Gleason's, and Bruce Silverglade took him under his wing, and he started training and worked with a variety of trainers, won the Golden Gloves, and eventually turned pro. And here we are. It's a journey still in progress, but he is the American success story.
So you have Kobe Bryant on.
Yeah, he was
good. You had Rampage Jackson on. You had Manny Pacquiao on, and now who do you have on?
Yuri Foreman. We're excited. It's gonna be fun.
Yuri's the best.
Yeah.
You know, Manny Pacquiao loves basketball. Is there any other sport that you love and you're good at?
I think I'm okay with soccer. You know, I love soccer.
Do you play any musical instrument?
Me, a little bit piano. You know.
Perfect.
You play?
I play saxophone and I sing. I do a duet.
I have a band right here.
Come on, man. Manny Pacquiao sang with us. You can come.
I could play that.
Play-Doh.
Hey, how are you?
I see you have the titties out representing. Yeah, how cool is that?
That's cool. I think it's the first titties in Jimmy Kimmel.
No, the second. Matisseau was the first. Wait, maybe he didn't have the titties out. I'm not sure.
I'm sure he had.
You were just on Jimmy Kimmel. How did it go?
It was good. It was a lot of fun. That's cool.
He asked you some funny questions?
Yeah. Kind of, yeah.
You gave him some funny answers?
I hope so.
It was a good experience?
Yeah, it was. It was a lot of fun. Walk of Fame.
When are you coming back to LA? Now that you're a big star.
Well, you know, now I have to take care of the major business on June 5th. Good willing, yeah, shortly after, you know.
So there you have it, superstar boxer Yuri Foreman. And tune in June 5th, Yuri Foreman, Miguel Cotto. In Hollywood, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting. How do I do that?
You're very good. Reporting.